All right, it looks like people have all gotten in, so we'll go ahead and get started. I first want to thank all of you for joining us this morning. I'm also very pleased to welcome our panelists. We are pleased to welcome this morning Congresswoman Jennifer Gonzalez-Colon, Congresswoman Elena Ross-Lightnin, and Age United President and CEO Jesse Mylan. Congresswoman Gonzalez-Colon serves as Puerto Rico's sole representative to the U.S. Congress. A lifelong Republican activist for Puerto Rican statehood, she entered elected office in 2002, becoming the youngest member of the Puerto Rico House of Representatives. She went on to serve as Speaker of the House and Minority Leader, and she is currently the co-chair of the Congressional HIV/AIDS Caucus. Welcome, Congresswoman.
Thank you.
We also have Congresswoman Ross-Lightnin, who spent nearly three decades as a member of Congress representing South Florida. She served as chair of the House Committee on Foreign Affairs and was on the House Permanent Select Committee on Intelligence. Before her departure from Congress, she also served as the co-chair of the Congressional HIV/AIDS Caucus. Welcome, Congresswoman.
Thank you.
And finally, Jesse Mylan, Age United's president and CEO. He is a lawyer whose career has included leading many HIV programs and organizations at the regional, national, and global levels. He has served and is currently serving on a number of nonprofit boards and government advisory boards. He has been living with HIV for more than three decades and has been with Age United for 5 years. Welcome, Jesse. And so we're hoping this morning's conversation will be organic and free-flowing, but I did want to start us off with a question. And this is for both of the Congresswomen in particular. What led you to want to take on the responsibilities of co-chair of the Congressional HIV/AIDS Caucus?
Elena or me?
Whoever.
I think you Elena, go, Jennifer. You go, Jennifer.
First of all, thank you all for inviting me and letting me participate in this. I think, I mean, in Puerto Rico, for an example, we do have a lot of people with HIV, more than 49,000, to be more precisely. And that means that all the deaths reported among persons living with HIV in the island to December of 2018 led to more or less than 29,000 people. So this is something that goes across party lines. This is something that affects everybody, affect people regarding their age, their faith. So I do think that to this day, we should be doing something about it. And this is not the first time. I think when Ileana was in Congress, she was the one leading the Republican side with Barbara Lee. Now, since December of last year, she approached me. And it was an immediate yes, because I do believe in equality. I do believe in that we should fight and get the resources for this sickness and how we can change that. There are many issues. There are many provisions and bills that are filed in Congress. The executive initiative that was announced in the State of the Union, but yet, that there's a long road to cover, and that was the reason I was involved. And I do have a lot of people and that came to my office in the last 3 years supporting this, and so for me it's like it's normal. I do believe that we all should be doing something.
Well, I agree with you, Jennifer. When I left Congress, they had AIDS United said, we need someone to be the Republican co-chair for the HIV/AIDS caucus, congressional caucus. And there was no doubt, no hesitation. I didn't have to think too hard. The name Jennifer Gonzalez-Colon was number one, number two, and number three, because she's passionate about her issues that she cares about. She wants the best for the people of Puerto Rico. She knows that every important problem needs a bipartisan solution, and she works just as well with Republicans as with Democrats. And that's the kind of person I was looking for to take my spot as a Republican co-chair of the Congressional Caucus on HIV/AIDS. Jennifer understands the issue because you just heard her presentation, how her island, how Puerto Rico is impacted by HIV/AIDS. And that's what prompted her to accept this position. And that's the same reason that that I took on the Republican role for that caucus, because in my area of South Florida, we have been heavily impacted by this pandemic of HIV/AIDS. Now we have so many great scientists around the world and so many great strides, so many good solutions to this problem, that we all know that that diagnosis is no longer a death sentence. We have so many examples right here in our own panel of people who are living with AIDS, right, Jesse? And it's not a diagnosis that anyone wants to receive, but you know that you can live with it. And I appreciate what AIDS United has come up with, and I hope that folks who are watching this go on their website, because they have a roadmap for federal action. And it is wonderful. It's bipartisan. It's something that Jennifer agrees with and everybody would agree with. Elimination of HIV health disparities, access to HIV care and treatment, preventing transmission, addressing societal and structural barriers to effective HIV prevention, maintaining U.S. leadership in life-saving HIV research, and supporting the meaningful involvement of people living with and vulnerable to HIV. Jennifer Gonzalez Colon believes in this mission. She works hard at it. Her voting is synonymous with making sure that we can eliminate this dreaded disease as we've eliminated others in the past. So thank you to us, the AIDS United. Gracias.
I'm going to interrupt you just a second. I think Ileana Rosletinen led the way for many new members of Congress, supporting what we believe and fight with passion for what we believe. Those are big shoes. So for me, it is an honor to do this. And again, every day, two persons are diagnosed with HIV in Puerto Rico. That's a lot, knowing everything that is happening. We do have more than 686 kids between 1980s and 2018 that were diagnosed with HIV in Puerto Rico. Just today, 400. So those numbers are not supposed to be there. We need to do something to stop this trend. And that's the reason we are leading that legislation with Barbara Lee in a bipartisan way. As coming from Puerto Rico, I don't have a vote on the floor. I do vote in committees. So that's the reason everything I do is bipartisan. Everything I support gotta be bipartisan, because that's the only way to get things done.
Well, my heart is singing because, Congresswoman Ross Layton, you mentioned our roadmap, and Congresswoman Gonzalez Colon, you just mentioned bipartisanism. And I've really been wondering, what are the conversations? Because our roadmap has been so helpful, I think, and it's going to be helpful for current and future administrations. But how do you maintain a bipartisan commitment to HIV? What are the conversations like? You all have been on the inside with Barbara Lee and others on the other side of the aisle. What are those conversations like that could create this bipartisan coalition to support HIV and AIDS?
For me, I will tell you that Barbara called me last year. I know, recommended by Ileana. and she just made a few questions about HIV on the island and how it was impacting healthcare, how it was impacting families. So for me, it was a no-brainer. again, this is a health issue. This is not about a certain group of the community. This is not about a specific gender. This is about, you know, healthcare. This is about health. So in that sense, I joined her immediately when she called me. She was a little bit surprised, I may tell you. But afterwards, we revised the bill that we filed and dropped in the House, which is called Repeal HIV Discrimination Act, that will provide modernized laws and policies to each state to eliminate discrimination against people living with AIDS. And I think it's not just at the federal level, we're talking about state levels and regulation that should not be in place or should not be unique. Or additional to a burden to individuals that are being diagnosed by HIV. So this is a step-by-step plan. That roadmap from AIDS United should be, you know, the blueprint of what we can do together. And again, this is not an issue. This should not be a partisan issue. So that's the reason I'm honored to be the Republican lead at this time.
Well, I agree with what you said, Jennifer. And you know, Jesse, when you look at the voting record and the philosophy of Barbara Lee, she could not be more different than the voting record that I had and the philosophy that I had and the voting record that Jennifer has and the philosophy. We're conservatives. Barbara Lee is progressive to the nth degree. However, on this subject and many other subjects, there are no party labels. It doesn't matter. There's no spectrum of, you know, conservative, a conservative with AIDS and a progressive who has HIV. You have the disease. There's no discrimination, and there's no, that disease does not look at someone who's Republican and Democrat. And that's what's formidable about Jennifer, because for most politicians, if you're a Republican and you see Barbara Lee's name there, you think, oh no, you know, I have to be very careful. She said this and that. But she said, you know what? We have people in Puerto Rico who are dying, people who don't have access to health care. That is more important than any differences that I could have with a person with their political affiliation or their views. And that's why in the years that I headed the caucus as a Republican, and now Jennifer does, I worked very well with Barbara Lee. And there was not any problem, there was not any friction. And I think that what Jennifer does with Barbara Lee and what I did with Barbara Lee is a good example for the whole Congress, that you can overcome these problems, these differences, and come together to solve a terrible health and societal problem. So I congratulate Jennifer for taking this on. And once again, I'm going to plug your fact sheet, because it is just so good. The AIDS United fact sheet. And this is what Jennifer is all about: eliminating all anti-LGBTQ policies, prohibiting discrimination, decriminalizing HIV, getting funds for the Ryan White HIV/AIDS program. There's no Republican or Democrat side on fighting AIDS. Jennifer's on the right side, Barbara Lee's on the right side, and that's the only way that we can get good legislation and good funding to pass. So I'm very happy with Jennifer's leadership. I'm happy with Barbara Lee's leadership. And that's what we need more of in Congress. We're so divided. It's so bitter. It's you against me. And when it comes to fighting HIV/AIDS, it's only we. There's no me and you.
Well, I think this is fabulous. And I'm wondering if I could get some advice, because you all have been such a great model for this, for a creating bipartisan coalitions and reaching across the aisle. But for advocates on the outside of Congress, it's not always that easy to reach across for, if you are identified as, you know, progressive, and to have a conversation with conservatives, whether it's other members of the state house or your city council or just in your community. What is the way that we can do that? How can we actually reach across the aisle outside of Congress and in the streets and in our communities?
Jesse, I will tell you what happened to me. When I received that call, of course, you study the biography and all the references of the people who are calling you. And I said, oh my God, we're not going to agree on anything. I mean, you know, we are so apart in many of the issues. But yeah, and that happens a lot to politicians and members of Congress. But what I've been doing since I've been elected to State House and then in Congress, being the first woman to be representing the island in Congress, is, you know, I know who you are, but tell me what's the issue we need to work on. And once I identify, you know, what's important, what's the main issue, what's your problem, and what is my problem in representing the island, I embrace the issue. So I think we should not put labels on people. We should not be saying, oh, I'm not going to meet that guy because he's a conservative. I'm not going to be meeting that lady because he's too liberal. I think what's the issue, what's at stake, and what's at stake is the health of many people and the lives of many people and their families. So in that sense, you know, you just took the issue and you embrace it. And that's what I've been doing with Barbara Lee, surprisingly. And again, it's been very respectful. Another issues like LGBT issues, that's something that I'm supporting as well. Not now, when I was in the State House, I was the only Republican voting for that as well. And the reason for me is I believe in equality. I live in Puerto Rico, where 3.2 million Americans are disfranchised. They cannot vote for the president. They cannot vote for the senators. They do not have equal representation in Congress. I cannot be selecting how equality is going to be defined, or what issues are equals and what not. You know, equality is equality. So healthcare is equality. And in that sense, I should be, you know, representing my island and all the people, including the people with HIV. And that's the reason, you know, find your topic. What's bothering you? What's your cause? Embrace it with passion and share it. I think in my office, what I do, if I believe in something, I will say it. If I don't believe in that, I will say it. Let's find a common ground to make things happen.
I agree, Jennifer. And that phrase that you just ended this presentation on, finding a common ground. And that's why your organization, Jesse, is so important. We need groups like AIDS United to bring us together. Because if you leave us, I'm talking as a former member, there will be too many divisions because, as Jennifer points out, too many labels. And somebody will tell you, oh, you can't work with that person because that person is too liberal. So it's organizations like yours, Jesse, that bring us together. And that's why I know in this age of COVID, we can't get together physically, but to have any Zoom meetings on a bipartisan manner, those go a long way to bridging those gaps and having people understand this is a human issue. It's not a Republican problem or a Democratic problem. We've got to come together to solve it. And it is solvable. And an organization like AIDS United tells us, because of your research, this can be fixed. This can be solved. But we need to come together.
And coming together, boy, is that important right now. I'm just wondering, you know, you've been talking so much about how you've gotten to do what you've done, but I'm wondering about the future too. You know, if we find ourselves in January with one party in the White House and two parties in Congress, or if things change, how do we continue that bipartisan coalition if there's a big change, or if we have a divided executive and a divided Congress? How do we continue this? What do you think?
Good ideas are to be supported, no matter who's the one speaking about it. I mean, and that's the way you embrace things. One of the policies, you know, the president's new ending the HIV epidemic plan that he announced in 2019 at the State of the Union, it's a 10-year initiative that will provide funding reducing the numbers of, you know, the goal is to reduce the numbers of new HIV infections in the United States by 75%, including more than $700 million to fund this plan. You know, good ideas, you need to support it. Again, don't put labels on issues. If at the end of the road, we're going to be solving a problem, a huge problem. And in that sense, any initiative, when Barbara called me regarding this bill, I revised it. You know, we added some issues because in Puerto Rico, we do not have many of the requirements of discrimination policies that you may have in other states. So we were sharing those examples and how we treat our people in the island. So again, it's not about the person, it's about the final goal.
Yeah, and I was just so happy to hear President Trump in that State of the Union say what you pointed out, Jennifer. So that's very important for people to know, because it is in your fact sheet. It says both President Donald Trump and Vice President Joe Biden have stated they want to end the HIV epidemic in the United States within the next 5 to 10 years. So we have both presidential candidates. Whoever's going to win, we don't know. That's up to you, the voter, every one of you who is listening in. You have the power. Get engaged, participate, and vote. And what a shame that the people of Puerto Rico, as Jennifer points out, are not able to vote for the president of the United States. It's nonsensical. That's why I'm with Jennifer. We need to make Puerto Rico a state. That's another issue. We can do another Zoom on that. But it's not fair, it's not right, and I'm for Puerto Rico statehood. But everyone else, you have a real say in this, and both candidates, isn't that just remarkable? They want to put an end to AIDS in the next 5 to 10 years. So you're right, Jesse. We don't know what's going to happen. Who's going to control the Senate? Who's going to win the House or the White House? But everyone needs to work on the same goal, eliminating the scourge of AIDS. And it's laudable that both parties have come to that conclusion.
And securing the funds for Ryan White programs, as well as housing opportunities for persons with people with HIV. I mean, that's important to secure and maintain those resources.
You're so right. Ryan White HIV/AIDS program needs funding. We all need to get together, and the housing discrimination has to be done away with. I agree. And that's why she's my friend. I agree with Jennifer. but even someone with whom I have strong disagreements on international issues, like Barbara Lee, and Jennifer has these disagreements as well. But we work together because this is a problem that we can solve if we work together.
I agree. If we work together, we can do a lot. And ending this epidemic, I think, is so clearly a bipartisan issue. And boy, have you two inspired me today to make sure that we continue to keep that coalition going.
Well, Jesse, let me ask you a question. How are you? When were you diagnosed? How are you feeling? What's happening with you?
Well, I've been living with HIV for 38 years.
Wow. Who would have, when you got that diagnosis 38 years ago, you thought, I'm never going to see, you know, the next Christmas or Hanukkah, right?
But you know what? I had a doctor who said to me, I am not going to let you die. And he got me into a clinical trial in 1989. And that clinical trial probably helped. And I was really grateful for that because it probably stopped things from moving really fast. Until we got to a place in the mid-90s where antiretrovirals became available. And that, you know, has been a lifesaver for literally hundreds of thousands of people in this country, millions around the world. So, you know, getting into access to care and having somebody that you can work with who understands you and that you make sure they understand you and you work together, that's a model that I think we're replicating and trying to expand across the country, right? Getting people into care. Because that one conversation meant the whole world to me.
Oh my gosh.
And then just when antiretrovirals became available and making sure that I was adherent and learning to watch my viral load and my CD4 count and understanding now U equals U, right? Undetectable equals untransmittable. It means not only that I'm going to live, but also that not transmitting this to someone else is really wonderful and helps not only with prevention, but it also helps with the stigma that so many people living with HIV carry around. So.
Now, Jennifer is way younger than I am, so she's growing up in a generation who already understands that HIV/AIDS is treatable and it's not a problem. But an oldie, but a goodie like me, for us to hear the story of Jesse living with HIV for 38 years and look at how terrific he looks, it's just nothing short of a miracle. Your generation comes to accept that's a modern medical reality. But for me, it's like a medical miracle.
Right. You know, we just had the 30th anniversary of the Ryan White program. It's hard to believe young Ryan White was 18 years old, but he died 30 years ago.
Wow.
You know what, that I'm hearing you guys talking about this generation. I'm not gonna say generation gap, but you know, how we perceive these situation before and now. And I remember, I'm 44 years old. So I remember all the media and all the TV ads, you know, trying to people not to get infected with HIV. So it was like a part of a generation growing up about knowing about HIV. And you don't see that any longer, just, you know, organizations like AIDS United and many others fighting for the people, a lot of grassroots that are doing their part as well. But this is something, I mean, I remember during the Bush administration, there was funding, you know, for fighting not just HIV, but the malaria initiative as well. And growing from 10 year from $2 billion to up to $8 billion in federal funding to all these programs. And then during the Obama administration, again, increasing that amount of money, that's something that should lead us to what's going to be the next step or the next phase of fighting HIV.
Right.
We are approaching the end of our time. We got started a little late because of all the Zoom problems this morning. But I'm wondering if any of you all have final thoughts as we wrap up.
Well, thank you, Warren and Jesse. I just want to say another. I just want to give another shout out to Jennifer, because to me, she's a picture perfect portrait of what a politician, an elected official should be. She's accessible. She's got a superb personality. She just pops on the screen. And she's nice, she treats people with respect, and she's serious. She studies the issues, she weighs this, and her acceptance of being the Republican co-chair of the HIV AIDS Caucus just says so much about the nature of her bipartisan spirit. So I congratulate Jennifer. I think it speaks volumes about her bipartisanship that she accepted this great responsibility. And I thank AIDS United for this opportunity. I want to be in your corner always. Jennifer.
First of all, thank you. I feel so humble every time you speak about me. I mean, you're a role model for many Latinas and for many women and members of Congress as well. I want to say thank you to AIDS United for inviting me for this. And again, I just put myself out there in any way I can help. Not just in Congress, but, you know, spreading the word and educating about how this is affecting everybody. HIV does not discriminate. Over the past three decades, this epidemic in the United States has expanded across lines of age, ethnicity, gender, sexual orientation, and that means that we need to fight together to end it. And that will mean a lot of resources and appropriations. That means supporting the Ryan White program. That means supporting housing opportunities for people with HIV. And as well, if I got the opportunity, you know, there are two main programs that I should be pushing for. One is passing the repeal HIV Discrimination Act, that Congresswoman Lee and me introduced in March of this year. This bill will modernize how we treat people with HIV, eliminates a lot of discrimination in states and in the federal level. And the other one is that I do believe is a critical policy. It's supporting the ending HIV pandemic plan, which is a 10-year plan that needs to be funded. And I hope we can all work together in that sense. So again, I'm all yours. Thank you for the opportunity. In any way my office can help, I'm going to be there.
Well, I've been honored to be sandwiched between the two of you. Congresswoman Ross Layton, we would not be where we are today without the leadership we've had from you and Congresswoman Gonzalez-Colon. We won't be getting to where we need to be without your leadership. Thank you both. It's been an honor
to be
part of this conversation.
Thank you, Warren. Thank you to AIDS United.
Well, I'd like to thank both of the Congresswomen and Jesse for their time. I really enjoyed this conversation, and I think it's quite amazing how quickly a half hour can go. I'd also like to thank our translators and thanks most of all to all of our viewers. And just so you know, we will be posting this to AIDS United's YouTube page sometime this afternoon. It needs to do some technological things to upload, but it'll be up sometime this afternoon. And I thank you all very much, and I hope you all have a great day.
You too.
Right.
Thank you.
Thanks to all. Bye. Blessings to all. Bye.